Everyone else sees it. Recording in progress. All right. Everybody's coming in at different times. I don't know where you're at. Hopefully, if you're indisposed, that means you're in the bathroom or taking a shower. Don't undo your camera. Right? You guys all know Zoom etiquette. And we're here as the school is beginning to open back up. And I'm so excited to have this opportunity. First of all, does anyone have any questions before we start? You know, I know a few of you had me before, you know, they haven't come in yet, but a few of you actually had me. I checked the list out, I check it twice to see what people have been doing up until now. How's everybody doing COVID-wise? Is everyone all right? Have you been able to schedule your classes and things like that? Is everybody all right? How do we do things? And what's the power that we have as individuals to be okay? All right. What I'm going to do is, I want you to open yourselves open to possibilities. Is everybody all right? Who's out here? Okay,
is Hi, everyone? Professor. My name is Karina. Hey, okay. Karina.
All right. You know, this class is a little different class. I'm going to ask some questions before we get started. And I'm going to ask you. I don't know how many of you is anyone here a freshman or a sophomore? Is anyone here a freshman or a sophomore? You're definitely not a freshman, but you won't be able to get in here. But is anyone like a sophomore? Is everyone a junior or higher? Okay, so I always begin with that little thing. And, you know, some of you took my class before. See it, I see you. This class is a little bit different. I'm trying to up the stakes in this class. You say, oh boy, now he wants to. I want to up the stakes, meaning I want you to get more out of this class than you could possibly ask for from a class. Yes, Melissa.
Hi, Professor. I'm a sophomore, actually. So.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so you're going to suffer. Just kidding. You're not going to suffer. You're not going to suffer. I'm glad you're here. I always feel that the stuff you're going to learn in this class is translatable. It's translatable for the rest of your career as a college student, and in addition, for the rest of your life. And, you know, does anyone, you could put it in the chat or whatever you think, if anybody has it, what would be an excellent super duper outcome for this class besides getting an A, right? You know, people say he's an easy professor. I am kind of easy, but I think the concepts that I leave you with are life changing. I don't think it does you any good to have all these complicated theories and theorems and principles and notions and paradigms in your brain that you can't apply. We need, you know, we are in a situation, a lot of times we have a phenomena occur and we react to that phenomena. Sometimes we're nervous, sometimes we're scared. And so we need to be able to react to that phenomena without becoming overwhelmed. Does that make sense to everybody? Or what do you guys think? Make sense? You know, how many of us enjoyed, some people may have, but how many think this has been a fun ride, just full of laughs and giggles during this COVID time? How many of you think that? Has any of us thought that? This has all been laughs and giggles?
No, I know it way.
Has. No way, right? It's been real. This is keep, you know, we're not, what school do we go to? We go to Brooklyn, so we can keep it real. So one of the things is this, the whole idea of education is radically changing. No one's got, I'm not saying this, not calling anybody out. I'm not doing it that way. But I want you to know, no one has their picture up, but for me. And I see myself constantly. You know, I used to be a little bit about me, your professor. After I graduated from college, I tried to house homeless women and children. Good afternoon, Anthony. I used to try to, Solomon, good afternoon. I had a company called Renaissance Development Corporation where I tried to house homeless women and children in New York. It was a pretty dynamic program. What we were going to do is have women working in one area, primarily in afternoon. Sana. We were going to have people working in the very buildings and living spaces in which they were, hairdressers, daycare centers, those types of things. And what ended up happening was that the corruption was so bad here in New York City and in Philadelphia that I said, you know what? I got to know what the heck is going on. I went to college, but I got to get another degree because this corruption is crazy. This corruption's crazy. So I went to law school. I went to law school. Before I went to law school, I was selling men's shoes. I was selling men's shoes. I couldn't get a job. It wasn't because I didn't want one. I wanted a job, and I couldn't get one. And so I was selling men's shoes. But I took that as an opportunity to think differently, and that's what we're going to learn about today as well. Thinking differently is really part of negotiating. I thought differently about my job. I was working at a store that doesn't exist anymore. It's called Lord & Taylor's. They closed down about 2 years ago. And so I was working there, and I became the number one shoe salesperson in the United States for that company, that division, doing some of the things you're going to learn now. I didn't know the stuff that I'm going to teach you now, but it was very effective. And some of the things I'm going to teach you, incorporating into the negotiation class, I use that so that I, no, I don't, Solomon, who cares about my, Solomon, I appreciate you saying I have an impressive resume. He's influencing me, isn't he, right? That's part of, that's my job, teach you how to do what you're influencing me. I read the email, right? But the reason why I'm telling you this, and you saw the email, but I want to impress upon you that the thing I want you to know is I'm going to pour everything that I can into this class so that you can extract and stand on my shoulders going forward for the rest of your career. It's a pretty high standard to say, but I want you to exceed me by a mile. I want you, if I end up making in the next, which could be possible in the next 5 years, $50 million, I want you to make $500 million and help 100,000 people or 500,000 people. Because a lot of times people set limitations for us and we have prisons in our minds and we think that's all we're supposed to be or all we can be. But I want you to know that the sky is the limit, right? The sky is the limit. And so in some degree, I'm going to break it up. So you guys at least talk to each other, see each other for a few minutes. And what I'm going to do is we have was 208 precisely. And so what I'm going to do is break you up into about five or six groups just so that you can talk to each other, just so you know some people's faces in the class. And then from there, or maybe I'll actually wait the next 7 minutes because people might have some questions about, we were in person and then we were online and then we're going to be in person. What I'm trying to do is this class is this. I want us to have online flexibility, but with in-person sensibility. Oh, I just made that up. It sounds good. Feel free to quote me. What we're going to do is at some point in time, I'd like for us to meet if that's possible. That makes sense for everybody. I'd like to meet. I think there's a very, very powerful dynamic when you meet someone, you see them, you go, hey, it's great to see you, right? That's part of negotiation. That's part of negotiation. People are coming in. See, Ed, it's been in my class before. Siad, you were in my class, right? Siad, you were in my class before? Mr. Ahmad, were you in my class before? I thought you were. I wasn't sure. The feeling was that you were. But in any event, so I wanted to get that out right at the beginning. Though we're online, I'm going to want us to meet maybe once or twice in the semester, maybe more, depending upon if you get a lot out of it. Because I want to, here's the key thing. How much time do you have before you influence someone? I want you to think about that. Someone type it in the chat. How much time do you have before you influence someone? What do you think?
I think it depends on the relationship between those people.
How quickly can, that's a key thing. 4 seconds, 15 seconds, people put it in. It depends upon the relationship. But I'm going to show you how to instantaneously influence people. And here's the most important thing. The most important person you must negotiate with, the most important person you must influence, I hope you remember this automatically. And don't forget, because if you don't come to another class, if you don't remember anything else that I say, remember this, the most important person to influence is you. That's right, yourself. See, Ed. You are the most important person you influence because from you, all thoughts and thinking becomes possible about the world. A lot of people say, we're not at Harvard, are we? Who thinks they're at Harvard University? Those two people call security because they're in they have a mental condition, right? But the question becomes, do we think because we're at Brooklyn College that we're not at a place like Harvard? Well, we say, of course, I'm not at a place called Harvard. The question becomes, can you make this situation where you're at Brooklyn College, your advantage? Because you're going to learn about what they talk about at Harvard. We're going to talk about what they learn at Stanford University. And you're going to learn more than what they learn. I hope you heard what I just said. People said this neat class. Yes, who's saying something?
This is Abu.
Hi, Abu.
I joined late. I came back from Professor Long's class.
How did you like him? He's a great professor, isn't he?
He's a good professor.
He's a good professor. Lynch. But the one thing you missed, Abu, everyone was taking down my name and number where they're supposed to send the extra $450 to me personally. So let me give you that information. Just kidding. Just kidding. That's what happens. Sorry. You come late. What's going on, Abu? How can I help? What's going on?
Oh, no. I just want to know if I came in late a little bit.
No. That's not what this class is about. You know, a lot of people say, well, I don't show up. I have students who contact me. I've been teaching about 13 years now. I have students who contact me 13 years later and say, Professor, I did not take your class seriously, but I want you to know that every single day, the things you said to me changed how I look at myself and my world. I don't care if you think I'm a joke. That doesn't matter. I want you to take me seriously. More importantly, I want you to take you seriously.
Yeah.
Does that make sense, Abu?
It makes sense. I was just saying that, like, the time my class ended, right? It took me a little bit while.
That's okay. I'm glad you're here. And thank you for letting me know. People are still coming in. All right. So I'm happy with that. We're going to get started in another 2 minutes. We'll break you up into some groups. Interact. Don't have to look at the bald-headed professor. You have to look at him. You get to look at each other. I want you to if you're in a place where you can't safely release your picture, don't do it, right? But if you can, I want you to introduce, the peace team training. I want you to know, the peace, outside of Brooklyn College, I don't think I put that as big a deal. I represent a group of about religious people in the Buddhist community, about 950,000 people outside of New York City and in this area. I work with the Muslim groups. I work with Jewish groups. I work with Christian groups. I work with those who don't believe, agnostics and atheists, to make what'd you say, sir?
You're like an interfaith leader, like for all religions.
In a way, I guess that's what you call it. Thank you for saying that. I don't know about that. We'll see at the end of the day. You don't get to call yourself anything. Let's see what you do until the end of your days. Then, you know, everyone's days are numbered. So what do I do with my time? We're going to learn about that as well. I talk about that in my happiness class. But the main thing I want you to understand, the peace team training is something. We started something called the New York Peace Team here in New York after a series of attacks occurred against Muslims, Jews, and Asians were being attacked. And so what we did was we started something called the New York Peace Team, where people learn bystander intervention training. We learn nonviolent communication. We even learn how to disarm a person who may have had a weapon in a dangerous situation. A lot of the times I say, run as fast as you can. But if that's not possible, what do you do? How do you protect your life and others' lives? So I would like to incorporate that training into this class. And so I have to find out if one of my good friends is going to be put on the board. I hope he is going to be put on the board. Muke is his name. Done a lot of types of training with me, and it's helping establish that. Hold on, I've got Professor Bissell here. He's calling me, and this sound. Hi, Professor Bissell. I'm in my class here, and they're all hearing me speak to you. Say hello. Say hello. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah, they are the best students ever, and I will call you later after my class, my friend. Okay. All right. All right. Peace now. Yeah, he's the deputy chair. He's a phenomenal professor. I hope you see my energy is a little different than some other professors. So I want you to not match my energy, but I want you to match the energy with inside of yourself, which is called possibility. All right. How great do we want to be? I already put it pretty high. I already told you. I've already set the bar pretty high. I've already said we're not gonna settle for what Harvard does. You say that's not possible. We're not going to settle for what Stanford does. And some of you may not know what Stanford, who Stanford University is, but Stanford is one of the greatest colleges in the United States. It's on par, if not better, than Harvard University. So we're not going to settle for what they do, because we're from where? Brooklyn. And so we have to have skills that they don't have. Hope everybody gets that. We have to have skills that they don't have. Many of us are first generation college students. We're not even sure about everything for ourselves, even though we're juniors and some of us are seniors. We are graduating soon enough. But we're not sure about the world tomorrow. We've got masks on, need inoculation, and some of our families and some of us saying, we don't know about this or that. What's going to happen tomorrow? What job am I going to have as I'm going to compete against technologies that have yet to be invented? And I'm here to tell you, don't worry. You'll be fine. You're going to have skills after this class that is going to empower you so that you can negotiate with whatever circumstance you are in your life so that you can get the outcome you want. I hope you understand all that. Hope it's not too much right now. I've been fired up. I've been thinking about this class and you guys are looking at your pictures, finally looking at it, looking at your names, thinking about you every day. You say, what kind of, this guy needs a life. He needs a life. Well, no, why have I been doing that? Because I've been so concerned about the students that I've been teaching. I'm so concerned about what's happening in your lives. Some of you have family members who are sick. Some people are afraid to go out. Some people don't have jobs. Some people are worried about them making the rent. Some people have to go back to jobs that don't pay them enough money. Parents are turning around, well, what good is your college degree going to do for you? We need money today. We need to send money back home overseas. I have children. I'm aware of all that, and I want you to know that I take it seriously. So we begin with the end in mind. We begin with knowing the challenge and saying, great, fantastic. Where else would you rather be than right here, right now? You may say, I would rather watch TV. I'd rather be with my boyfriend, girlfriend, significant other, as they used to say when I was younger. They didn't like to say boyfriend. They'd be my significant other, right? Whatever that meant, right? Right? You may not want to be here, but I want to compel you to be here because you're going to find by being with each other, not with me, by being with each other, you will find a way to look at your life differently. You'll look at everybody else's lives differently. And more importantly, you'll look at your opportunities and your futures and your family and your hope for this country and the world much, much different. Yes, Rama. I see your hand up.
Hi, Professor.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm good. I just came to class. I'm not feeling good. I'm at the hospital, but wanted to let you know.
No. That's too much information. This is okay. I appreciate you being here. You stay on as long as you can and relax.
The service, the internet is not really good.
No. Don't worry. Please go back. It's going to be taped.
Thank you so much.
I'm better on tape than I am live, so that's better.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. All right, please feel better.
Thank you.
I was talking about that, right? I don't know what your name is, Food, right? Food 77, so I cannot call you by your name. Yes.
Sorry, Professor, I don't know why it's like that. My name is Sada. Did you take attendance? I just came like a
few I will be. What I do is I take pictures of the screen. Aha! They say he didn't take, look, let me show you. I pull up my little camera. But most of the time people don't, why is he looking at it? That's why I take a picture of the screen. And then I know who is here and who is not. And then if you say extra things, I eventually remember your names. I've taken pictures of everybody here so far, of their names, you know. So I take that and then we go from there. So let me break you up. The question we have to ask is, how are you doing and why did you take negotiation? Does that make sense? So we're going to talk, think about that for about 9 minutes. Talk amongst yourselves. How many people do we have here? We have 450. Let's say seven. Let's say eight rooms. I love the sophisticated technology that we're living in today, right? Can we do it? Can we do it? Yes, we can. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. All right, everybody, we'll be back in about 9 minutes. To introduce yourselves to each other. The question is, how are you doing? And why did you choose negotiation? Open all rooms. There you go. You guys put yourselves in the rooms as you see them. There you go. Go into the room if you can. Go into the room if you can. I've got a few people here. Ming Hao Hu, there you go. Ming Hao Hu, Solomon. Nuspam, go, go, go. Ming Hao Hu, Leslie. You just came in, right? Leslie just came in. Here we go. Leslie Carrara, there we go. Join, 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 move to. Leslie. Join the room, join the room. You're in a room, you're supposed to be in room 7. Join the room. All right, got a few minutes. I'm gonna pause the recording. Start the call. All right, we're gonna put that back. People come back. I'm gonna close all rooms because people are starting to come in and it's getting unwieldy. One more minute.
Hi, Professor. Can you hear me?
Hi. How you doing? How you doing? You okay?
Hi. I'm in campus. I'm using on PC on Wi-Fi, but it doesn't work. I don't know.
Yeah. No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Okay. That's why we have recordations. We have recordations. Yeah. Don't worry. Yeah, I'm gonna close rooms in 1 minute. So sometimes you're going to get bounced out. They would say, no, every room is sophisticated. But when students get on campus and everybody's utilizing the you know, the internet, all of them are going to freeze. You know what I'm saying? That's just the reality. Yeah. All right. So don't feel funny. Let me close the rooms. Rooms will close in 60 seconds. That's okay. But I appreciate you letting me know. That's the reason why, you know, I just knew. I'm chairman of the department and I know what Brooklyn College can do for real.
Yeah, I was kind of nervous. I was trying to send you a message. I think I'm broken up.
No, that's okay. You're good.
Yeah, my internet is broken. Yeah.
No, you're here. I appreciate it very much. I appreciate it.
Professor Lynch?
Yes.
I got a question.
Yes, sir.
So it's not really for this class, but with regards to another business class, I haven't received any email from the professor that's teaching 3421.
Who's teaching that class?
Professor Nidin.
Okay, he's new. So what happened was they put his class on hold, but email me after the class and he's getting on top of it. You should be able to get access to his class on Blackboard today. All right?
You should be able to do it. No, like what I'm basically saying is that some of the students like that's supposed to have him for Tuesday, right?
Yes, sir.
They told me like they received the email and it's for Wednesday. Like that's okay. What I'm saying. It's like I'm not supposed to take the class on Wednesday. That's how I
said it. But I'll figure that out. You send that to me and I'll make sure I get to the professor, okay?
All right, thank you.
All right. All right, so here we are. Well, is anyone hopefully most of you are semi-okay. We have a lot of students, relatively online, 51. You know, I sometimes give talks to about 100, 200 people, depending upon the Zoom situation. I have to do this, let me just tell her. Carolina, I'm actually in class right now. Can I call you right back afterwards? Can I call you right back?
Sure.
I'm with the students on. They all hear you. All right, bye now. That's the office staff. That's Carolina. She's one of the office staff who work at Brooklyn College in room 217, Whitehead Hall. It's phenomenal. But I wanted to ask, so what we got something, will anybody, you don't have to show your picture, but tell me, why are you taking this class? Why are you taking this class? What do you think? What's good about this class? What do you think is going on? Why are you taking negotiations? What can we get out of negotiations?
Well,
That's fair, right? What can we get?
You can.
Go ahead. I'm listening. Yes. Who was saying something? And then Tierra.
It's Abu.
Abu? Yes, sir.
Like, you can learn how to facilitate, like, when it comes to, or like, because especially in the business world, you need to know how to, like, how to, the communication part, because that's really important if you're trying to get something done. So that's why I'm taking this class, as well as it's a major requirement for my major.
I hear you. That's beautiful, beautiful. Miss Jenkins.
Hi. So I'm taking this course because from personal experience in the fall, in the near past, I've learned about knowing your worth when it comes to looking for jobs. If you have the opportunity to negotiate your salary, do so. But again, it's all about knowing your worth. And even in your personal life, yes, communication is a big key, but also we're learning, with the name of the course, also with conflict resolution. Conflict resolution goes far past just figuring out a problem and solving it in just the workforce. You can also utilize that information in your personal life with your children, yes, coworkers and classmates.
I think that's a beautiful answer. Tiara, that's a beautiful answer. Solomon in the chat box says, persuasion, transactions, communication, and helping to sell not only something, but yourself. Rama said, I took it because I believe that communication, negotiations is very important in our everyday life, mostly in the business world. I think those are true, right? I think those are all very, very true, right? I think that we often think of negotiation, a lot of times people put pressure on themselves. And I've been in high pressure negotiations recently. I've been in negotiations where a company that I was helping to work with, they were trying to be squeezed out. The company wanted $5 million. It may sound like a lot, but the company's true worth is about $100 million. About $100 million. And if they can get over this hump right now, the company's worth, as they know it to be, will be $1.6 billion. Why am I telling you that? Unless they give me the money and I share it to you, right? I'm telling you this because the same things I'm telling you in this class are the very same things that you're going to know how to do and to avoid so that you can feel comfortable in your negotiations, in your communications, in the business world, in your family, and how to present yourself. They sell something but yourself as well. I think that's very, very important, right? So let me see if I can share the screen, and I want to share the screen right now. If I can do this quickly, because this is always something extra challenging, but let me go here, and then I can share the screen. Boom, let's see if it does it this time. If it does what I want to do. Yes, it did. Okay, and I'm gonna share the screen. This is the syllabus. We're going over the syllabus really quickly because you all can read. You're in college, right? You're in college. You know, I have a quote up here at the very top. Never negotiate. John F. Kennedy is my favorite president for a host of reasons. And if you ask me later on, I'll tell you why. But one of his most famous quotes was this: never negotiate out of fear and never fear to negotiate. Do you think that a lot of us are afraid a lot of the times?
Yes.
I think a lot of the times, and I think we're being conditioned to be afraid. I don't have a mask on. Do you have Corona? Do you have the Omicron variant? You know, it's like we're constantly having to deal with societal fears. And if we don't take on those societal fears, people think we're kind of odd. But I'm going to say it at the beginning here, the most important negotiation you will ever have is with yourself. Because at the end of the day, only you can control should influence your fear. Only you can influence your fear. And we should never fear to negotiate. We should never be so sure of my position that I'm not willing to listen to another human being and their concerns. my boyfriend, my girlfriend, my child, my significant other, other people's religious persuasions, their economic status, their whatever it may be, political, religious, doesn't matter. I must always be willing to see another person, because in that person lies the potential for my greatness and their greatness. I know it sounds weird to say this at the beginning, because it's a different way of thinking about things. I'm going to change, and it came to me as I was thinking. I told you, I really was thinking about you in this class. I've been teaching this class for a minute, for over a decade now. And one of the subtexts I would put under here, right here, under negotiation conflict, I would call it the art of thinking differently. That's why I feel you should show up. Because what we're going to learn together, it's not like once you do something, it's like, oh, once I worked out one day and now I'm, you know, Olympic swimmer. You're going to learn ways of approaching life's problems, concerns, negotiation points. It could be, I want to go to the movies. You don't. I want to go to dinner and you don't. How do we resolve those differences in a way that is both beneficial for me and you and better than either one of us could have thought possible? And fundamentally, the way I teach this class is the art of thinking different. That's why, while it's not on the syllabus, it's on my personal syllabus that I wrote preparing for this class. And it says here, negotiation, conflict studies, mediation theory. We're going to learn all of that. You'll learn some of the jargon, but you're going to know certain things that most people won't know. You're going to, I say it again, you're going to learn more than what they teach at Harvard. You're going to learn more than what they taught at Stanford University, because I'm going to actually show you the videos from those people. So how are we going to work this? What I've been planning, I'm going to have a video presentation on Monday that you guys can see at your leisure. Does it make sense? This is not in the syllabus. So that's why I took the time and waited. You guys are going to see a video. I'm going to send out maybe on Sunday or Monday morning. This is a video I want you to watch. And if I can't get the copyright, I'm going to show you and say, hey, on Wednesday, we're going to see this video and we're going to discuss it on Monday or something like that, mix and match. Because there's too much information that I want to give you. Doesn't make it difficult. Matter of fact, I try to make it easy. Everybody who, I don't know, maybe one or two of you stumbled into this class without looking at ratemyprofessor.com. I wouldn't do it. I make sure that my professor's sane. If I were you.
I do that.
Everybody should be doing that. If anybody, if this was a classroom, no. I always say, what'd you say? What'd you say? Oh, no. I always judge if a person didn't do that, I would say, I'm nervous about you, right? So we're going to find out what moral responsibility, because a lot of times people think negotiating with people is to trick them, to take advantage of the person, and it's not. In order for you to do well, you must make sure that you are in a position to feel good about yourself. So while this is not my happiness class, and spiritual values in the workplace class, I still believe that you must act ethically in all of your activities, because the most important person you're going to negotiate with, and who most important at person at the end of the day, isn't whether you made $15 million and you have enough money to take care of your entire family. That's not the issue. The issue is, can you look at yourself with dignity and respect, and you can feel good about what you're doing every day? We are born, we die, and in between we decide how we're going to serve. The question is, how are you going to serve? So you will develop a firm negotiation foundation from which to effectively understand various negotiation approaches and allow you to think about negotiation in new and exciting ways. I think that's really important. One gateway which we will touch upon is to look at negotiation through the prism of stories. It doesn't make sense to you now, but it will. And once you learn this concept about stories, you will want to know about other people's stories. But the most important story is your own. And you'll understand that sometimes your story that you have, your beliefs, your values, and your structures about yourself can act as a prison through which you can't get out. And sometimes that stops you from negotiating properly. For example, if you're in a relationship with the other person and you think the other person, I'm this and they're supposed to treat me this way, they're supposed to worship me, I don't know, make it up, then you're going to have outcomes that you don't want to have. So it's, hold on, living the dream. Professor Klein, I'm actually in class. I'll call you back, okay?
Okay, sure.
Fine. We must understand another story to avoid harmful conflict. That's the key point. We must understand another person's story if we avoid harmful conflict. Just because you have something that makes you feel uncomfortable doesn't mean it's harmful. Think about putting your hand in a fire. If it didn't feel uncomfortable, your hand would be burnt off. So feeling something that may cause you conflict or uncomfortable sensations may not be bad. It may save your relationship. It may save your relationship with your child or your significant other. Someone put in the chat, do we have to watch the movie Negotiator this weekend? Yes, yes, yes. Because you won't be able to answer the questions if you don't. It's a great movie. It's a great movie. All right. In fact, what I normally do with that, as I'm going in this, I usually have people come in the first day. So if we had met, but the problem is this whole Omicron thing, you know, ruined my stuff. I used to come in with popcorn and I gave everybody in the class popcorn and wipes. And they gave water, popcorn, wipes while we watched the movie in the class. And the reason why I do that, I want us to have a shared experience. I want you to know I'm always negotiating with you and you are always negotiating even with the other people in your class. I want you to get that. And so here are the learning goals for the class. Critical thinking, communication. Yes.
I got a question.
Sir.
So there's a, like the emails that I get sent on the Blackboard doesn't really get sent to my email. Like it's using the email I use for another college. Is it possible for you to send notifications?
You have to go into the system. That's a systemic question. You have to contact Blackboard and they can change it for you. Okay? That's what you have to do.
Blackboard?
Yes. You have to call Blackboard administrator. So on the bottom of Blackboard, if you have any questions, help, call the help desk there and they'll help you.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. So in this class, we're going to do a couple of things. Critical thinking, communication, quantitative reasoning, critical thinking. Most people think, what does it mean to be critically thinking? It means to think differently about an issue. You're going to learn about informational literacy. That means taking information and understand what they are saying. You're going to know about ethical reasoning. And here the homework one, homework two, and term paper. It's easy. We're going to go over that later on. But the papers are easy. They're not hard. These are the books, Difficult Conversation. That's the book that has to, you need to get these two books and get the film, The Negotiator, right? Difficult Conversation is a great book. What is a difficult conversation? Sometimes it can be, I don't want to date you anymore. I could be, Mom, I can't come home. I'm seeing someone. It could be, I don't want to go to work today. You know, your boss, you believe you're doing a great job and your boss doesn't give you a raise and you believe you deserve a raise. Difficult conversation. So we talk about, and if they don't have training sessions, though I'm one of the people on the New York Peace team, I will provide you with that training. And these are recommended texts. And so that's what's going on here, right? That's what's going on here, this spring break and all that. Okay, are we okay with what we see here? Is that all right? We take a quick break on that. And tell me what you guys think. Does that make sense what we saw? This is basic. You can read the rest of it, academic thing. I don't want you cheating. Well, the whole purpose of the homework, here's an important point. And it tells you about the deadlines and about the homework. And I don't spend 20 minutes doing that stuff. I mean, I'll do it as the papers come up. The papers are not being done for me. They're being done for you. If you do the assignment and take it seriously, I guarantee you, I guarantee you'll see things differently. Yes, if you go to the syllabus on Blackboard, there'll be a link, or if you type in the Negotiator film in the YouTube video, just look in YouTube, boom, it'll come right up, okay? All right, so Let's start off. Yes, who's this?
Abu.
Oh, yes, sir. Okay.
With regards to the like negotiation, like what specifically are you gonna like focus on?
Don't worry, I have questions that you'll see. There'll be some questions that I'll put up and you'll have to answer it. Okay. I'll do that for you. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's all right. Don't worry. All right, so that's where we are there. And now let's watch, let's share. Hopefully I did this properly and it's gonna work beautifully. And let's see, I want you to think about, because in the negotiator, the film, we think that negotiations that we have with family and friends and strangers, I asked you how quickly could you influence someone? Yeah, and how soon can you influence someone? And I want to just, you know, and let me see what someone has here. I just want to see what they said. Is this class online only? Because that's what I honestly prefer. Yeah, don't worry about if you can't meet in person. All right, don't worry about that. You know, it depends on the person. Well, I want to show you a video of how quickly you can be influenced by people you're not even aware of. Let's watch it. Can everybody see the screen? Just let me know. Can you see it? All right.
Yes.
So here we have a street scene. Let's just set it up. We can see by the bus, this is not Brooklyn. Right? And the people are from a European city. It's English, so that's why I have it here. It's England. Let's watch what happens. Make sure the sound's up. I put it all the way up. This is a little low, this video. And here we go.
Excuse me, do you know which way the actual Pleasure Beach is, the fun fair?
The Pleasure Beach? I'm not really from round here. I think if you're from the main one, if you follow down, just right. Go down this road here.
Yeah.
Keep going, and it's on your left-hand side.
So it is down there?
Yeah.
That's the tower, isn't it? But it's you don't mind me asking, do you?
No, no.
No, you're happy to give that to me. Okay, so it's down there. Yeah. Great. All right. Sorry about that. Cheers. Thanks ever so much. Great. So it's just down that way. Can you just grab that? Just for a second. Can I just grab your watch? And you've got a phone on you as well. That'd be terrific. Can I just grab your thanks. I'll take that off. Lovely. Cheers. I just grab your phone as well and your house keys. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, so it's just literally just down there. Yeah. Lovely, I'll grab that. So it's straight down there and...
Keep going on your left-hand side as you go further down the road.
All right, lovely. Thanks ever so much. Cheers, mate.
Thanks.
Thank you, you're fine. Thank you.
So what's happening here?
Thank you. Sorry.
It's difficult to explain because somehow it felt natural to give them to him. Until I got a few yards down the road and then I started to think, what's happening here?
Just hold that a second. Cheers. Right, I'll just grab the others back off you so I can keep them. Cheers. Thanks ever so much. Thank you. Cheers. I think you're heading that way, man. Thanks ever so much. Cheers.
What happened there? Anybody? What?
No way, this is real.
What happened? What did we see?
He got finessed. I don't know.
He got finessed. Right? That's a Brooklyn way. She said that boy got finessed.
Yeah.
Right? What happened there? Stranger comes up to him, asking the time. Has a few words with him. The next thing we know, he takes his wallet, his keys, and he walks down the street. Then the guy wakes up and then he comes back and says, hey, where's my wallet and the keys? And he does it again. Are you guys saying, wait a second, I'm from Brooklyn. That wouldn't happen to me. I'm in New York now. I'm from Brooklyn. I'm not playing that. How many of you think, right? I can't believe it. At the end of this semester, what you saw as, and I'm going to remember, a lot of you won't even remember we saw this video. Because some of you think that's a fake. Some of you said, that's not real. That's some staged thing like on Twitter, click TikTok, right?
I would have been the guy that walked past him and was just watching it happen. Like, what's going on?
Right? That's what we think. We think that wouldn't be us. We don't think that that would be us because we're sophisticated New Yorkers. But let's watch what happens to a sophisticated New Yorker. That man is Darren Brown. He's the number one, I would call, stage influenced hypnotherapist in the world. I was on stage with him one time by fortune. I saw his show in New York City, and he influenced me so that I would get on the get on stage. And one person put in here, either it's fake or he was gullible. Question is, what makes us gullible? And can we think differently? The art of thinking differently so that we're not gullible too. So let's watch. We just saw this one. Let me start this one. We just saw this one asking for a while. We just saw that one, but let's watch the one over two. It's right. And this one again is the same gentleman, Darren Brown. So let's watch what he says. Can everybody see it?
Yes.
All right, here we go. And some little things here, let's see.
But in America, I'm not the massive and lovable star you know me as here. I shall exploit my anonymity and try some daylight robbery in the financial capital of the world with a wallet full of blank paper.
This is a little cheeky.
So does everybody understand what he's going to do? He's going into stores in New York City and he's paying with plain pieces of paper, blank pieces of white paper. He's going in to buy things.
This will be the first time, and I imagine the last, that I've met with these salespeople.
I'd like to buy some of your soul, please. Yeah.
How many would you like?
Maybe three fillets.
Three fillets?
Thank you.
1855.
Where are we paying that? Thank you. This is a fantastic place.
Thank you.
You're a local? Have you always lived in this area?
20 years.
20 years, Jesus. Okay, so how much was that?
1855.
I was a bit intimidated by the subway system. I didn't want to go on it, and then someone said, you know, it's okay, take it. Take it, it's fine. So I did, but it's amazing. And you, where did you live before this then?
I live in Staten Island.
Staten Island, which is just over the water, isn't it? Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, yeah. Thank you. You too, thanks.
See what he did? He just paid with paper in New York, right? Right?
Hi, hello.
I'm going to skip this one. I'm going to come back to this later on. I'm going to come back to this guy later on because it doesn't work.
I thought you exactly.
It didn't work with this guy, but I wanted you to see this. Here we are. Here we are at the Diamond District. We're about to go to the Diamond District. Here we have the Diamond District. He's going to try and go into this store, into the Diamond District, and pay with paper. You see, one person says, what year is this from? How old are they? How old are these folks, right? Well, it's not that far back. This may have been about 10 years ago. So let's watch. Maybe about 7 to 10 years ago. Let's watch.
Very good. I'm kind of interested in maybe one of these bands down here. These are platinum, are they?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's very nice. So, can you tell me about it? So it's.
This is a platinum band with a platinum.
Mm-hmm.
4,500. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Okay, fantastic. Well, I will take that as it is. I'll give you cash for that if that's okay. Thank you.
All right.
Great, lovely. I'll let you box that up. Thank you very much. It's the nearest subway here. Just on the corner down there. So is that north or south that way? Or
north.
That's west that way. Okay, so that's right, north up there. I've been thinking the wrong way. Thank you very much indeed. So straight down there on the corner.
Uh-huh.
Fantastic. And yeah, I was a bit intimidated about using the subways here, but my friend just said, take it, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. I was a bit intimidated about that, but that's great. So straight down there, that way down on this corner,
yep.
That way on that, straight down there. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, goodbye.
Don't let this be you. Don't let this be you, everybody. I hope you're paying attention. This is day one in negotiation. That's where you are right now. And I'm trying to show you. We may think that this is impossible, but this was in the Diamond District, right? How did that happen? It's not fake at all. You'd get slapped if you tried that right now. No, it still happens all the time, but I'm going to show you how. How many of you, after COVID, it's over? You say, I'm going mall shopping, right? We go mall shopping. Is that what we do? We want to spend our deceased notables. We want to just give away our dead presidents. Don't believe everything you see. Well, I'm going to tell you, you're going to learn how to do that. But the question is, you don't want to influence people in a negative way, because if you influence the people in a negative way, who's the first person that's influenced? Yourself. So you're going to learn why that worked. And I'm going to show you how powerful it is. And we're doing things automatically without thinking about our lives and what the impact is on ourselves and other people. So let's watch another video. See, this class has a lot of videos. Because I could have told you that story, but it's another thing to see it actually happen. That's why I use the video. Let's watch it. All right, I told you, don't be this guy. What about the next one? Let's watch the next one. It's very short, 2 minutes. Can everybody see that? I don't know if everybody can see. That's the Palisades Mall. So again, it's not in Okeedoke, Kentucky. Right? I don't know if some of you, the Palisades Mall is not super far from Brooklyn. Many people go to the mall, or used to go to the mall before COVID. Some of you might want to go to this mall. And I want to show you how we are influenced. Those were instances where people are being influenced on an individual basis. But what happens to us collectively? Can we be molded? Can we be influenced to do things without our consent? Let's watch.
American shopping malls, modern cathedrals to spending money. They're designed to disorient us and make us stay longer than we need to. Every brick is there to manipulate us to buy. It's the perfect place to find a large number of compliant people to affect.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Palisades Mall. We hope that your shopping experience is an uplifting one, and I'd like to bring to your pay attention some very special offers today.
What you're hearing in the background is a public address announcement I've pre-recorded and played throughout the shopping center. After about half an hour of absorbing it, they should be ready for their final message.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Palisades Mall. We hope that your shopping experience is an uplifting one, and I'd like to bring to your pay attention some very special offers today. Details of our special offers can be found handily by the elevators, so why not come right arm up and see for yourselves. Our special offers will only be available for a short period of time, so all those customers wishing to reach up and grab this exciting opportunity should do so now.
Everybody raised their hand. It was just weird because I'm walking around and he's like, now, and everybody raised their hand.
Someone gave me a phone call and I was talking to my friend. He was talking to me. When the guy was like, do it now, I put my hand up. And then when I turned around, everybody was doing the same gesture and I was like, what was going on?
We were walking around and we heard an announcement and all of a sudden we all raised our hands.
It was weird. We turned around and that, like, everyone had their hands up in the air. It's really weird.
We had our hands up too.
Really odd.
Sorry.
Just letting that sink in for a second. Hope everybody sees that. We are being influenced often to buy things and do things and feel certain things about people that we would never do on our own. The question I wrote down as we're speaking, you can't see it, but there it is. I said, what are you being influenced to do? if you are feeling fearless and loving to your neighbors, to friends, to people who look different than you, do you feel that way? And if not, why not? Who's making the decision to make you feel a certain way? So I start off with my phrases. It's called stand guard at the gate of your mind. All right, put it down there. I said stand guard at the gate of your mind. If you don't, someone else is in there influencing you. If you're not at the table of your mind, you're on the menu. Hope you hear what I just said. If you're not the one sitting at the table deciding what to eat and how to eat it, you're on the menu. We laugh and say he's giving away his money in an instant, but we may give our money away in a whole host of other ways that we're not thinking about. So let's watch one more video. No, first I'm going to talk about this. Then I'm going to watch the video. I had to think about what we're seeing. You guys have too much quiet. You guys got that nervous, even though I can feel, even though you guys don't have your pictures up, a lot of you. I can feel the like, what the heck happened? How did that happen? So I'm going to show you already. How did that happen? How did that happen in the two videos we saw? And it's in your syllabus. You don't have to look at, I am looking at the syllabus. The syllabus says, in order for you to talk about the negotiator, and it says ABS formula for Monday the 7th, you're going to read chapters 1 and 2. And then the ABS formula, why it's so important. And so I'm going to introduce it right now ahead of time, and I'm going to go over it again. Because the ABS formula is something I learned. I'm a certified hypnotherapist. And when I was studying hypnosis training, I found this fascinating. And that's what made me start to look at these other videos. And I started to wonder, how are we being influenced? What are we being influenced to feel? Who are being influenced to not like and who to like? So this is what you want to get a person into, a state where they will be influenced by you. They call it in hypnosis a highly suggestible state. And that's why people in the mall just raise their hand up without even thinking. First one, these are the based upon the six, ABS, let's do the ABS for me. First thing you have to do is absorb the attention, bypass the critical factor, and stimulate an unconscious response. A, absorb the attention. You absorb someone's attention. Remember he said, this is not everything he did, but I just want you to know, hey, do you mind stop? He stopped him. He absorbed his attention. The next thing is, think of it like this. Have you ever gone into thought about going into a club and you have to be dressed a certain way, you have to have a certain look? Ideas don't penetrate your mind or get into your mind unless they appear to be like other thoughts in your mind already. That's why people tend to, if they're conservative, they tend to stay conservative. If they're liberal, they tend to stay liberal, right? Because the ideas that are presented to them, in order for it to penetrate their thinking, has to conform to what they already know, right? So first we absorb their attention, then we bypass the critical factor. The critical factor is like a guard at the gate of a nightclub. He or she won't let you into the nightclub unless you look the part. Same thing with your ideas. And S is stimulate an unconscious response. It could be, I want to fit in. I'm angry. Whatever it is, I'm going to stimulate an unconscious response. And that is the basis of what you saw him do to get the paper, that the money. That's what he paid with paper. That's what he did to get the guy's wallet and keys. It wasn't fake. It's very real. And I haven't even shown you how he did that. But I'm showing you the principle behind it. Because once you understand the principle, you'll understand the technique later on. No, I'm not trying to get you to go like this. Mom, I want $50 more. And I'm not trying to get you to do anything like that, right? That's not what I'm trying to do, right? But I want you to understand how people are influenced. So it's ABS formula, right? All right. And after this, I may talk about something that's very, very important, which is called the six human needs. It goes into this. So we talked about the ABS formula, and then I'm going to put down my notes here that I'm keeping as I talk about. That was the ABS formula. And then after this, I'm going to talk about the six human needs. Let's watch the next video. How much did we see absorb attention, bypass the critical factor, and stimulate an unconscious response? We saw it in all three of the videos we just saw. Let's watch one more. It's very short. Okay, let's go here. Can everybody see that? Can we see it?
Yes.
Yeah. All right, fantastic. Let's watch. So here we have some people in, looks like a waiting room, and that's what it is. Let's start.
That question, we set up a hidden camera experiment to see if this woman would stand up at the sound of this tone, simply because everyone else is. You might be thinking you'd never go along with this, or would you? After just three beeps, and without knowing why she's doing it, this woman is now conforming perfectly to the group. But what happens if we take the group away?
Elaine, please.
Okay. Now she's alone, the crowd is gone, and nobody is watching her, except our hidden cameras. What do you think she'll do? She's now conforming to the rules of the group without them even being there. Now, watch what happens when we introduce another outsider who doesn't know the rules.
Have a seat, and they'll be out in just a couple minutes. Great, thanks so much.
To. Think she'll teach the new guy what to do? We kept the cameras rolling as more unsuspecting patients arrived. And slowly but surely, what began as a random rule for this woman has now become the social norm for everyone in this waiting room. Here to explain what's going on in their brains is Jonah Berger of the University of Pennsylvania.
This sort of internalized form of herd behavior is part of what we call social learning. Starting at a very early age, when we see members of our group perform a task, our brains literally reward us for following in their footsteps.
When I saw everybody stand up, I felt like I needed to join them. Otherwise, I'm like excluded. Once I decided to go with it, then I felt much more comfortable.
Conformity is how we become socialized, but it can also cause us to develop bad habits or repeat past wrongs.
And it's why even this rebel, who wasn't standing for any of this nonsense, eventually joined the ranks. And the only thing more shocking than seeing how easily conformity...
All right, let's stop there. Someone's wrote in the chat, I watched this before in my psychology class, right? But now you see in a different application, don't you? You see the application in real world influencing people. So, but here's the key point. They're good. I wanted to take some classes to get a master's and a PhD in psychology, but I'm just too busy. I always want to learn more because I want to be able to give you more in my classes, but this is very good. That's much more believable. That's because psychiatrists and psychologists are not using their techniques to influence you that way. But guess what? Darren Brown is. Right? So we're going to learn how to do that. One of the books one book that's very important in this technique is going to be called Mirror and Matching. And it builds upon this. And one of the things we may not have heard in your psychology class, people say that, but how many times do people have stuff happen in the corona area that we've been era? People ask us to do things that we didn't feel comfortable with, but we did it because we wanted to just get something done for convenience. I did, right? I'm just being honest. If enough people are doing something, it's hard to say, I'll just leave. And that's why it's very important. We're asking, remember, I already started out, we need to be able to think. If you look back at my syllabus, I said critical thinking was the number one skill. We need to think critically, or people can always negotiate us because we put ourselves in a box that we can't get out of.
That's what we're going to learn.
That is weird. But that's called thinking differently, isn't it? The art of thinking differently about your life. Because you need to be the number one influence in your life. And so I'm going to start off, I didn't normally teach it this way, but I'm going to start in this class with the six human needs. Six human needs. Every human being, this is not necessarily, this is, I learned this when I was, yes, he's the professor's learning. Yeah, I got to keep learning. I got to keep growing. It's one of the six human needs. We're going to figure that out right now. Six human needs. First, we went through the ABS formula, right? Absorb attention, bypass the critical factor, and stimulate an unconscious response. That's what exactly what we saw. I know they didn't teach it like that in psychiatry or psychology class that you had, but that's exactly what you saw. The person's attention was absorbed by what? The beeping sound, wasn't it? They went in a comfortable place, the waiting room. So it bypassed their what? Critical factor. And people getting up stimulated and what? An unconscious response. ABS. So I'm going to teach you something else called the six human needs. And this is very important because if we want to, this is the beginning of understanding people's stories. So I'm beginning with the end in mind. You're going to, the last assignment deals with stories. But in order to understand stories, you have to know what motivates people. And you have to know why they do what they do. There's no crazy people. People just have different strategies. When you believe that and you, notice I just said believe, that's what I believe. You don't have to believe it, but I'm going to show you why I believe it. And you can either pick it up or not. You can see if it works, if it doesn't work. But if you pick this up, it has a chance to make you a lot of money and be happy for the rest of your life. So why do that? Who wants to have that? A lot of people want to have meaningless struggle for the rest of their life. I just am not into that. But it's up to you. Let's do the first one. Every human being, first human need, needs a certain amount of certainty. We all need certainty. Boo, type me, ask me certain questions. He's looking for certainty. That's why he's asking questions. Every human being needs certainty. Here we are. Some people say, is this going to be an online class only, or is it going to be in person? Why are they asking me that in the chat? Of course, they want to have certain modalities that favor them. That's okay. But the reason why they want to know, they want to be certain. Do I have to get on the Zoom call at 2:00 or 2:15 every Wednesday? Or is it going to be Monday and Wednesday? What's it going to be? I need to be certain. We've had enough uncertainty, haven't we? Can't go to school. I can't meet people. I can't go out on dates. I'm tired of it. Everybody's like, I need more what? Certainty. But too much certainty violates a biological need for change. We're on this Zoom call. You might think it's okay. I've had about 51 to 54 students be on this class. I mean, right now on the Zoom call, we've got about 15 more minutes left. But if I told you, say, hey, you know, I love this class. I like the way this class is moving. I love the way everybody's behaving. I love it. I love it. I love it. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to extend this class for the next 14 hours. Everybody's steam will go poop, 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 poop. Everybody would be going in a flash. I say, he's crazy. I'm not staying here for 14 hours because too much certainty is boring. Too much certainty hurts our biological need for change. You deal, how about this? You find this perfect person. You think they're great. They're going to first date. They come in and knock on your door. It's 4:30 in the morning. They say, I am in love with you. Here's some chocolate. Here's some flowers. It doesn't matter, woman. It doesn't matter. Here's some chocolate. Here's some flowers. Here's a stuffed animal. I think you're great. You're like, holy cats. No one's ever done this before for me. I'm a special guy. I'm a special gal. I'm a special person. And you close the door thinking, this person is really into me. Now, if they did that same thing, brought you flowers, candy, and a stuffed animal every day for the next 9 months, you'd be like, this person's crazy, right? And they knock on the door and you go, who is it? Guess who? They go, it's me. And then you go, how did I know that you'd wake me up at 4:30 in the morning and you brought flowers and you brought candy and you brought me a stuffed animal? Please stop knocking on my door. That's what happens. So if we have too much certainty, the second human need is variety. We need to have change. People take psychology classes. How many of you have been crying uncontrollably? I have. You're crying. Did you keep crying forever? No. Because even if you don't know anything, you put that person in the corner and they keep crying, eventually, physiologically, they're going to have to stop. Certainty and variety. Those are the first two. The third one is the most important for this class. This is the most important thing you can ever learn from this class. Say it again. The number one thing based upon the human needs of everyone is significance. Every human being needs to feel significant to some degree or another. And when you negotiate, when you go in for your interviews, when you talk to the other person on the other side, you want to make them feel, not through foolish things, you are going to be able to observe certain things now after you take this course and make the person you're talking to feel significant. You're having trouble with your significant other, your children, your father, your mother. You need to talk to them in a way that resonates with them with truth, not foolishness, with truth that makes them feel significant. That's why I cut my hair this way. Maybe I lost it, right? People have their hair a certain way, they wear shirts a certain way, they wear ties a certain way, they dress a certain way, they move a certain way, because we have a need to feel significant, to be seen, to be heard, to be understood. So when people say, you're not hearing me, you're not listening to me, you never listen to what I'm saying. If that's you, you're saying, you're making me feel what? Insignificant. And so the number one thing you can remember is in a negotiation is to make the other person feel significant. That's the third human need. Right. The fourth one is connection and love. Most of us don't. We all need to be connected to someone. That's what we saw in the video in the waiting room. She said it best. I don't like to feel out of place. It doesn't feel right. We all have a biological, societal need to be connected to each other. That's the fourth human need. But most of the time we say, hey, you know, we're dating someone, we're with them, and they go, you love this person? We're afraid to say the love word, right? Because if we say love, then we can get a chance of being what? Hurt. We can get hurt. So we'll settle for connection. Those people in the waiting room didn't say they loved each other, but they needed to feel connected to each other. That's very important. Connection and love, that's fourth. And the final two, the fifth and sixth, are what we call aspirational needs, right? Aspirational needs. The fifth one is, growth, right? Growth. You can have growth. Something needs to have you have grow. Everything in the world needs to grow. And the other one is contribution. It's usually contribution and growth. It doesn't matter the order, but contribution. You need to contribute. That's an aspirational need. To contribute to something other than oneself. That's why people will go and take a bullet on the battlefield. And all of us need to grow. I always just use the example, you know, if you took a flower, you have a beautiful flower as a rose, and you see it in a rose bush, and it's beautiful, it's springtime, not like it's icy out now, but it's springtime and it's beautiful. And if you took the tree and you ripped out the tree and you put it in your closet because you wanted to protect the tree, you loved it, you wanted to have a connection with it, but you put it in the closet so it didn't get sunlight, what will happen to that bush? It will surely die. Everything needs to be in an environment where it can what? Grow. That's why you're in Brooklyn College, baby. You're in Brooklyn College. You're a college sophomore, junior, or senior because you wanted to grow. You want to contribute. I want you to think about those six human needs. Those are very, very important. That's what we're going to go over in different iterations, different ways of looking at it. You're going to say, oh, I'm going to repeat it, six human needs. Reason why this is important, these six human needs are great ways of analyzing companies. You may ask, has this worked, professor? I guarantee you every semester I'm going to teach someone this and somebody's going to take it up. Someone's going to take the stuff we have in this class. Every semester I have someone who takes it and they say, I've increased my income three times. Or I got a job that was unbelievable. I went in for one job and the person offered me XYZ, which far exceeded what I wanted to do. Far exceeded. So you're going to, this is day one. I'm telling you, if you do the strategies and things we learn in the class, it will far exceed whatever goal you have. Getting an A is simple. Designing your life is what I'm concerned about. Will you be the one who influences you most of all? Will you be the one who changes your destiny? You're not relying on someone else to make you feel better, or a circumstance has to be a certain way for everything to be perfect. No, you're going to learn what stories you have. You're going to learn what's most important to you and what you value most and how you want that to happen. What do I mean by that? Two people say they love each other. Two people use the words, I love you, I love you. But one person values certainty and the other person say values significance. Or this, one person values certainty and another person values variety. Person says, if you love me, then you'll come home. Other person says, if you love me, you'll go out to these nightclubs with me and gambling. Both people using the words, I love you, but they have different needs that are met even when they use the words. So just because someone says something to you doesn't mean what they always say. I don't want to talk to you anymore. I don't want to talk to you anymore. The fact that they're screaming at you and saying, I don't want to talk to you anymore, means that one of their human needs isn't being met. So we just started out. What did we see? I'm going to recap before I let you go. We saw a couple of videos. A man get his wallet taken in the middle of the street in London. Right? Seems like it's fake, as has been said a couple of times in the thing. It's not. Because you're going to learn how he did it by the end of the semester. Next video we saw was the money. Right? We saw the money. Because I wanted to show you that it could happen in New York. We saw it happen in London. We saw it happen in New York, where people paid with paper money. And then the third thing we saw in New York State, the Palisades Mall, New York Palisades Mall, we saw where people raised their hands up mindlessly going through a mall, and they didn't even know why. They didn't even know why. And then the fourth video we saw was the conformity in a waiting room. And silently, a person was influenced to do something they had no reason why they were doing it, all because they had a need for connection and conformity. And we're going to see how that works out. But we're going to be the ones at the end of the day to figure out how we influence ourselves. We had two sets of ideas. The ABS formula, absorb attention, bypass the critical factor, and stimulate an unconscious response, and the six human needs. And I'm telling you, the six human needs are the key ones when you're having difficulties with another person. Why are they behaving the way they behave? Okay? All right. This is the end of day one. We're ready to rock and roll. We're going to learn a little bit more. We're going to be prepared. I'm going to send out another video I would like for you to listen to. Yes, Ms. Jenkins, I see your hand up.
Professor?
Yes, Abu.
I wanted to make an announcement to the class.
Yes, you mean where the semi-money?
No.
Okay, go ahead. I'll let you make it anyway, go ahead.
If anybody can send their email address so we can create a study group for this class, it would be helpful. Just so drop it in the chat.
All right, I'll keep it up. All right, so everybody says you can do that. All right, that's fair. All right, everybody, are we good? All right. I want to thank you all for your time. Please have a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful day. All right? Be safe now. Bye.
Question, Professor.
Yes. Where's the question? Where's the question?
Sorry. Can you just check your email today?
Sure, sure.
I just reached out. Thank you.
All right.
Professor, I just want to clarify. So we have basically, we meet every Wednesday, but we have work and preparation that's due on, like we have to do on Monday or like leading up to the class.
We don't have class on Monday, but I want to make sure that people don't say, oh, I don't do that. I don't want you going out to Coney Island and stuff instead of coming to the class. What I'm trying to say is I'm going to try to put something on the video for Monday, but we may have things we're going to discuss. I'll give you guys at least 6 or 7 days to stop before I do that. You know, I want people to know because there's too much information that I want you guys to see and to experience just for meeting on Wednesday. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's just too much. And I do it in an easy way so that you learn it easily and it's not hard to absorb. Like you guys saw that video, that wasn't hard to do, was it? It was easy. But you already know more about influencing people than 80% of the people on the planet Earth. Already, after one class, most people have no idea why they buy the things they buy, things are happening to them, what's happening. They don't even realize they're being influenced to negotiate, i.e. their money or their safety or whatever it is away from themselves. So I have to do it that way. So I have to, you know, have to give as much. So someone has the chat, what's link? That's why I put it in this. People can see it. Okay. And then anybody else have any questions? Are we okay? Tell me.
So I have a quick question. It's not specifically about the class. It's about my minor, because I'm minoring in business law.
Yes, ma'am.
I see that according to DegreeWorks, I only have business 33 feet to complete. But as I was trying to register for the class, it says that I need business or finance 3310.
Yeah, 3310 is usually maybe a prerequisite for that class or something like that. That could be the case. We have to go over that individually. But if you need that and you're a minor, maybe substitute them.
Sorry to cut you off, Professor. That's the same thing that happened to me before I had to join the class. Yes, I needed financial 3310. So for a person like me who's graduating this semester and I had to take 3310 in the summer, in the winter before, before I take your class, the only way I could have taken your class is I had to contact a certain email my advisor sent to me in order to do the prerequisite override.
I want you to send that to me because that shouldn't be the case. Not for my class, you shouldn't have that.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened. That's exactly what happened for your class. Like, in order for me to get in the class before it fills up, because by the time the 3 weeks was over in the winter, your class would have been filled up already. So it would have been closed. So in order for me to have done that, I had to go to my advisor. My advisor gave me two emails to contact, and then they had to do a prerequisite override, and I was able to get in the class before I passed 3310.
we got to check into that because that shouldn't be the case. That should never be.
Yes, I could send you those. I could send you the email.
Yeah, please do that. Please do that. Okay.
Yeah. Can you send me the email? Because I wanted to look into if I could do a prerequisite override because I'm trying to graduate.
I understand. You know, I understand. I look old, but I'm not dead. So I get it.
Yeah. So, like, definitely. All right. So I'm going to send it to your email, Professor, and then you can you can send it to Aaliyah.
Of course.
Thank you.
Of course,
it was. I thought it was going to be impossible for me to graduate in May because it was asking for that.
For my class, that shouldn't be there. Okay, so we'll do that.
All right. Okay, thank you guys.
Thank you. Anybody else? What's going on?
Yes, Professor.
Yes, go ahead.
This is Abu.
Yes, sir.
So I got a quick question. Basically, like I'm a business major with HR concentration, right? Like, is there any substitute class for finance 3310? And if you're majoring,
let me see. You have to talk to me offline because then I can figure out. I have to go through your schedule a little bit. But yes, you could do a substitute if necessary. Okay.
Like what about for like 3421? Is it also
3421, that's the class you were talking to me about before with Nitin, Professor Nitin, right? That's different. That's a
requirement class.
That's data analytics. That's right? A little different. We have to figure that one out, but we can talk about it later. I have to figure that out. I don't know off the top of my head. I know the other one, yes. We would take 2300 in lieu of 3310 right now.
Finance 2300?
Yes, sir. No, business management. Yes, BUSN, business personal finance.
What's it called? Business.
Personal finance 2300.
Oh, so you can substitute that instead of 3310?
I'll substitute that for you. I can't substitute if you're a finance major, but you're not. So if you were a finance major, I wouldn't do it. But for my, I will.
Yeah, because 3310 is like a really, I don't see myself doing, you know what I mean, right? I'm not going to do finance.
No, I don't want to have that on.
Why I gotta go through that stress? Like, if I'm not even gonna major in that, you know.
I get you, Sana.
Wait, Professor Lynch. Quick, yes. Last question. I'll send you. I'll give you a call later. Maybe we can talk.
Yes, sir. Maybe tomorrow. Right, tomorrow, but I'm busy today. Go ahead. It's all right. Go ahead, Sana.
All right. Take care.
I have a question. So, you said that there's going to be instances when we do meet on campus.
I'd like for us to meet. Was what I would like to do. There are a couple of things that I teach.
Yeah.
That are techniques that you need to be seeing someone.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
Right. There's certain things you're going to learn. It's called mirror and matching on verbally, which is very powerful. I've used it on, you want to upgrade your airline ticket? Use it. You want to get someone to go on a date? Use it. But there are other things that I want you to be able to do by seeing body language, which is very important. Does that make sense?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
So I want to make sure I'll be as creative and as fluid as possible. I think it's really great to see each other. You know what I mean? I do. I like seeing everybody. Yeah. I want to be able to do that in a way that's comfortable for everybody, but I also don't want to make people say, oh, I have my job. I know. I mean, hey, I've been in college too. I get it. You know what I'm saying? You know, people have lives. So I'm going to try to make it flexible, but when we meet, it's for a reason, not just to say, okay, let's have the regular.
I see.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Are you saying it's going to be like an option? Oh, sorry. Yeah. I just wanted to know if that was going to be like optional, what she was mentioning.
Yeah, no, it's optional, but I want you to be there if you can, because that's how you learn. You don't get, you know, how we model, you know, I mean, most of our lives, we model other people. That's how we learn. Me showing you and talking to you a certain way, I'm teaching you how to model someone. It's not just.
Professor?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sending this message to everyone. Can you please invite the number?
Yeah, I see that it. I see it there.
Nobody's inviting me yet. That's the problem.
Oh, I don't know.
You need to press the link and join the link.
Yeah, they
that's
have to
why.
Yeah.
No, I cannot join with my computer right now. It's because I'm using a separate computer.
Okay. I can't do that for you. May have to come back and we'll figure
yeah,
out.
Yeah, if any student can help with that.
Okay.
Can help them.
I have another question, Professor. Yes. So your office hours, on the syllabus, it says virtual office hours, Zoom. Yeah. So do we have to like make an appointment?
Just make an appointment, email me, and we'll try to be flexible, right?
Cool.
Try to make it Wednesday after this class. That's what I normally would do.
All right, cool.
All right, everybody, we're done for the day. Be safe.
Thank you too, Professor. Bye.
Someone please invite me.
Yes, someone invite me.
Okay, we will.
Thank you.
Okay. And Professor Lynch, what time are you free? It's possible.
You have to send me an email. Send an email, we'll go from there, okay? I know, remember, we talked already. You and I know who you are. We already talked, so don't worry. You're going to be fine.
Because sometimes I send you the email, you don't respond, that's why.
Well, I can't respond as quickly. You have to give me at least 48 hours to respond, okay?
All right. Thank you, Professor.